I have a very high self-opinion of myself. I consider myself the most complex thing in the known universe, which would be hard to argue against without using your own brain. I am always surrounded by mystery. It has held many philosophers, doctors, psychologists, and others curious about my essence. I am that mass of cells inside a skull, full of connections, electric and chemical impulses, encoding all the information that you know. Ever wonder why evolution tries so hard to protect this jelly mass of cells that consumes up to 25% of your energy? Well, in fact, Aristotle thought that I was just a mere radiator to cool down your blood. Well, the fact is that I'm part of a much larger system. The nervous system. I'm the headquarters, the boss office, whatever you want to call it. I am tasked with controlling most of the functions in the body. Processing data from outside world, perceived by your senses, processing it, integrating it into useful information with which you can make decisions. And I send out instructions to the rest of your body. I am so important, I get to be enclosed inside that skull, in my tail, in a tunnel of bones, suspended in cerebrum, spinal fluid, isolated from the general blood circulation, by the blood-brain barrier, because you can't just waltz in here, on VIP. There is so much to be known about me, and I can only tell you so much. You'll get to know me in other videos, but also because there's a lot of facts about me that I don't even know. I am your center of learning, and yet there's a lot to be learned about me. To be alive means to have a functioning brain. You're considered dead when I'm not working. It doesn't even matter if the rest of your body still works. Your thoughts, beliefs, personality, character, choices, perception, imagination, plans, judgment, feelings, journeys, desires. They're all thanks to me. My 3 pounds worth of mass is floating in fluid, which I manufacture in 4 ventricles and replace them about twice per day. I like to keep it simple. I have 2 halves or hemispheres, in each with 4 lobes, which are associated with certain functions like self-control, planning, reasoning, you know, that sort of thing. It works. All of this is made up of brain cells, neurons, and they have supportive staff, glial cells, with about 86 billion neurons and almost the same number of supporting staff. These neurons are the ones responsible for the immense network of connections that make possible learning new things, remember useless cat facts, and why that cake you ate last week was a bad idea. On simple view, may my surfaces fold into ridges and grooves called gyra and sulci, respectively, many of which bear the names of people who discovered them, studied them. Doesn't matter. The other part makes the cortex with gray matter, where the cell bodies of neurons concentrate, and beneath it there's the white matter, where the axons lie. This is why many would ask you to use your gray matter to think through something, but you also need the white matter to send out this information and make meaningful connections. So you better tell them that that sentence is incomplete. Other brains have studied me, charted certain areas. They agree that are devoted for certain functions. You know, like feeling a yearning for cake, planning and coordinating your movement towards the cake, moving and coordinating your muscles in order to take a bite of that cake, receive the sensory information of how good the cake looks, the texture and temperature of the cake, how sweet it is before you swallow it, and then later have abstract thought about how many calories that was worth and how much you'll have to run to burn it. But even knowing all of this, in general, everything about me is not fully understood, and research is always undergoing. Neuroscientists are the researchers that have devoted their brains to study how other brains work. You know?